All about running with the bag though. Pretty horrendous out here at the minute. Actually stopped raining for a few minutes. Quite nice. We got Raven Crag up there, Middle Fell Buttress, Bow Fell, Crinkle Crags up there. Back there is Harrison Stickle and Pavey Arc, all those wonderful places. There we go. All right, so equipment wise, this is what I've got. So I have this, which is critical, safe water. Don't get any, I hate getting any waterborne bugs, just my idea of a nightmare. Pump and fill up your water vessel. I love these shoes. These are Mutants by La Sportiva. They're absolutely gorgeous. I love them to bits. I've got some nice running socks ready to go and a warm top to wear when I'm out. All right, so I always use a rucksack cover. They're really light and they really, really help with just keeping things nice and dry inside your bag. Salomon bag. This thing's brilliant. It's got really, really good features. So I can put things like my phone in here with a set of headphones. Those are in here as well. I can put in here my glasses and just two good pockets. And a really good feature is this here. So it's got zips on either side, so you don't have to go in from the top of the bag. But the side here, it's got a special pouch that is just at the front. So there I've got my map and my waterproofs ready to go. All right, so let's see what we've got. Nice and quick. So food wise, I've got five wraps ready made and ready to go. So they're inside there. Got a bit of coffee. Got half a litre of water. Don't need to carry any more because it's wet around here in Cumbria. So there's always a bit of water about and I can always pump some more. I'm not a competitive runner really. Not really into the comp scene. So I can stop where I want, but even if you were, people might consider a really fast form of pump thing so they don't have to carry so much weight. Charger and a battery thing. Looking forward to the day when those don't weigh quite so much. Gas canister, warm stuff to wear in the tent in the evening. So a top and leggings. And this is the jet boil. Now this is major weight, it really is, but in the weather that I'm going to have tonight, where it's absolutely going to throw it down pretty much for the whole run and overnight, this means I've definitely got hot food, no question. My dinner, chicken fajita, pair of shorts, waterproof running socks. These they'll wear overnight tonight, but if it's really bad and my feet are soaking wet from today, tomorrow it means I've got dry feet and I quite like that. First aid kit. That's some freeze-dried peas to go in with my meal. My pegs for my choice of Bivvy. So black plastic bags I think are great. The waterproof covers are fine, the bags, but I do find they get holes in. A plastic bag is just cheaper. I've got a tiny little roll mat here, the size of my hand. It's not an insulated one, so that means that it's got these tubes that inflate. And I've chosen that for tonight because I think I do need a good night's sleep. It's going to throw it down. I've got what's called a Trek bivvy here. It's very, very small. It's Gore-Tex. It's single skin. I was going to take my bivvy bag, which is just a bag, Gore-Tex, but nah, the weather's going to be too bad. I don't want it, the rain hitting my face, even if I put my rucksack inside and I've got a bit of space for my head, I still won't like it. So in here I've got my sleeping bag, which is really good. I've taken a Helium Solo by Mountain Equipment this time. I like my Om one, but I've got the slightly warmer one by Original Mountain Marathon, so I've chosen the lighter version. Some underwear, very important to sleep in, nice and dry stuff. And then here's my Trek Bivvy right here. In the top, I have a buff, a little waterproof camera, my spoon, toilet roll just in case, and carry in, carry out as well. So there's enough to put all the waste stuff back in and carry it out so I don't make a mess of the mountains. I've got toothbrush, toothpaste, some lip salve. Got a face mask in case I need to go into a shop because we're in the time of COVID-19 at the moment. And an extra little plastic bag. That's it. That's my lot. So I'm going to go for a run. Total weight, including water and everything, is 7.6 kilos. If I didn't go with the jet boil, but I had a lighter little set of things that I'd light or something, and obviously if the ground wasn't a parched area, so there's no fire risk, then I might be able to lose half a kilo there. If I was bivvying properly, I could lose another 400 grams there. And if I took a slightly lighter rucksack with the slot down the back that also doubles up as a mat, I could lose this as well. So that would be another 450 grams lost. So that would be great. There we are. Time to go and get wet. So one of the most difficult choices to make that I find is what map to take. So I happen to, I live up here, so I kind of know where I'm going. But yeah, best plan sometimes when the rain's really coming in and, you know, it's getting really bad. So I like these Harvey's maps. This is a 1 to 40,000. And it's really good for running stuff. It's also not paper, it's plastic. So that map there, I can't remember when I got that, but I got it many years ago and it's still going strong. The other option is I take this. It's heavy. It's fully charged. I've got a spare battery as well, but I won't take that because I'm only going for a day. They're very, very good, these GPSs.
Get some food inside me now. So what am I going to go for? I'm going to go for a bit of hummus. Some pasta. Here we go, which I made yesterday. Just pop that in the microwave. All good. There we go. Boom. There we are.
So this car makes it sort of look like there's nice weather. My old estate. So I've got just waterproof jacket and trousers. Nice and light. My bag is ready to go. So shoes wise, I got these, which are my mutants. So over the top I've got these waterproof socks, which are then connected to my leggings. That's where this sort of, this plastic stuff's quite good. So if it's really chucking it down and I'm kind of sealed in, it's that or shorts. But today, because I want to go over the top, it's gonna be really windy, and I don't wanna get cold. So normally I would run in my, so I use shoes three times over. So there's serious conditions, which is kind of now. And then there's degraded into the next level, which is dry conditions, where I don't mind if I've lost all the tread. If the ground's dry and the rock is dry as you're running over it, then that's okay. So they've got a few holes in them and things like that. You can stitch these up. And then just change the insoles, and they're pretty good. And then the next level is when they're really ripped up, and those are for things like gill scrambling and canyoning and stuff. And then finally they go into the bin, which takes quite a while. But so today I'm wearing, I've just cleaned them, then I'm wearing my very, very clean mutants, which are going to get totally caked with mud, but at least I won't slip over. So there we go. Anyway, rucksack ready. Time to get out of here.
Maybe scuffled pike, something like that, because it's rained a lot, so there'll be loads of water up there. So I can pretty much camp anywhere I like tonight, which is nice. But, so here's the valley. It's Gimmer up there, which is a really famous Lake District climbing rock face. A bit buggy on the foot. This cap is a winner. Keeps the rain off my glasses, but also keeps the rain off my face. On to Angle Tarn. Here we go. So this is an option to camp. There's a lovely little tent camped right there in the nice green patch, and there's another one down here. So it's always quite busy. Fantastic. Yay. So one of the really good things about going out for these runs is that I guess being a bit time pressurized at times in our world, you get to make the most of quite short periods of time. So you could leave at 5 o'clock in the evening, get your bag sorted, get yourself out on the hill, bivvy out, run the next day, have breakfast out, or even just down in the morning, you know. Pretty horrendous out here at the minute. I was gonna video whilst I put the bivvy up, but no way. So here I am, a little bivvy, a great gear. Just gone to get some water. So pleased to have found a sheltered spot. Hey! So I'm in my shoes. So I've got a bit of wet stuff. So the most important thing is that the rucksack cover is really good because I can put my waterproofs and my wet shoes in there, which means they can come in the bivvy. So I've chosen this bivvy because it's actually got a hoop and it's quite spacious in here. So it should be nice and snug and warm. And I've picked a really good spot out the wind. It took me about 20 minutes to find it, but really worthwhile time spent. I find wraps are pretty cool because there's five in here. So you just kind of put them in a little flat thing so they don't get too battered, and then literally pull them out and they've got everything in them and they don't make a mess. They don't drop crumbs everywhere. So they're a really good idea for bivvying. Really quick and easy. Oh, comfy. Head torches wise, kind of like the reusable head torches in terms of the battery, so you can charge them up with a USB port. But the stuff of life, buffs really, really important. Actually stopped raining for a few minutes, which is quite nice. It was absolutely torrential rain. I've had to do a sort of warming dance right the way through the night as well. It's really cold. It got really windy. Time to run. Yay. You sort of pump this thing here. There we go. Clean water came out, so I just took this out of the lake last night because it was so wet. Now I can actually drink clean water out the end of this thing, which is really cool. So here it is, a voluminous little track bivvy. Quite cool. There we are. You just sort of slot yourself into the like trusty roll nut. And that's basically it. Oh, what a horrendously wet night. Oh my gosh. I didn't sleep very well at all. There you go. Ah. Time for a run, I think. Warm myself up. And it's off for another day's running. All about running with the bag though. That's what it's all about. That sense of adventure. It's really cool.